Well, I learned something very interesting last week. I've started to do a lot more research about trees as we get into agroforestry, trying to find trees, native trees that are beneficial for either timber, food, fuel, fruit, any of those things. And I happen to run across something called African Blackwood, which other people, it can be called ebony. It's not true ebony, but the wood is actually has very similar characteristics. And it is the most expensive wood in the world. Little did I know that we actually have African Blackwood, wow, that's a big bee, growing on the farm. This thorny little tree behind me, which is in the middle of our goat corral, is actually African Blackwood. Let's take a look at this. This tree, as you can see, full of thorns. As it matures, it tends to drop the thorns. Small leaves. This one has a really small trunk, and doesn't help that I've been cutting leaves off of this tree to feed our goats when they can't go out to pasture because of rain, because they love them, not realizing all the time that actually this was one of the more valuable trees that we have on the farm. Now, African Blackwood can sell for $100 a board foot. A cubic meter can go for $13,000. Now, this little specimen behind me has very little wood in it, because it's just the core wood that is valuable. There are some bigger specimens around, they're not easy to get to, but as you can imagine, it's very difficult. It's a very slow growing tree, 80 to 100 years before you're gonna harvest this thing that has any real wood value to it. So what's cool though is that some of the other specimens we have are of the age, they're not great size yet, but they're of the age where they're giving seeds. We're actually able to collect a whole bucket of seeds, and we've planted them out in our shade house, and they're germinating. So that's amazing. What is going to be very interesting is what's going to happen with these seedlings when we put them in our agroforestry system. Are we going to be able to get more growth, faster growth, to reduce the amount of years that it takes to get to maturity down to something reasonable? Because it's awfully hard to convince someone to plant a tree like this when the life expectancy here is less than 60. To plant a tree that you can only harvest after 80 years, very few people are going to do that. But it's something we need to think about, and it's a way that we can work this into our agroforestry systems as we're planting them out in the communities here. We can get a couple of these trees in here. As long as there's enough other trees in there that are valuable for food and fuel, these things can grow up, and our grandchildren will be able to harvest these things, and they'll be worth a lot more then. So, pretty cool. I had no idea that we had the most valuable wood in the world growing right here in the farm. We're excited to see if there is some opportunity for this in the future for the livelihood of, like I said, not us, probably not even our children, maybe our grandchildren.